This is the Johns Hopkins Zebrafish facility. We're a core facility that provides housing and care for the zebrafish for four labs here on campus that do their own projects and research using the fish that are kept here. Almost all of the major organs that human beings have, the zebrafish has the same organs, and most of them work the same way as they do in a human being.
So zebrafish are an excellent model organism to use for developmental biology because we can actually watch the process from a single cell animal all the way up until the developed fish. When they're born, they're in a translucent egg, and so we can watch them from the minute they're released from the mother up until they become a full fish. So what I really like about zebrafish and developmental biology is that we can use it to study how an organism forms, and that can apply to things like congenital defects in humans and understanding sort of how we can fix early onset pediatric illnesses.
A lot of the studies actually that are done here are based on the zebrafish's ability to regenerate. So you could cut the pancreas out of a zebrafish, and a few days later it will be growing a new pancreas, which is something that a human being cannot do.
So I have been working in the labs of Mike Parsons and Jeff Mum. We have been sort of comparing the zebrafish pancreas to the human pancreas, and there are many similarities, and we know that the cell type in the zebrafish that we think is responsible for regenerating the endocrine cells of the pancreas exists in humans. It just doesn't regenerate. So if we could figure out what that difference is, we could sort of hijack that system in humans.